Hello, this is Sean Copeland. I am Chairman and CEO of Regent Bank, and welcome to another edition of Regent Elevate. We are continuing our series on time management, and I really, really love this today's session, and I think you're gonna like it as well. It is on the power of managing your morning. A lot of times we think about time management and we think about our day and we think about how do we maximize and be efficient and bundle tasks, etc. But very rarely do people think about the morning. And I want to tell you why this really occurred to me. I am involved in Taekwondo, and Master So, who is my teacher and instructor, told me a story one morning about the power of getting up early. And he said that in South Korea, where he is from, the three major corporations, Samsung, Hyundai, and LG, their CEOs were always the first three people to come to this coffee shop that was in downtown Seoul, South Korea, right around 4 o'clock in the morning. And I thought, man, that's fascinating that those three very successful individuals would all really start their days early. And I begin to realize how important this is. So I started doing that as well. And first of all, before I get into my three tips for the morning, I wanna say, you may be listening to this and you may say, hey, I'm not really a morning person. That's just not what I do. I'm more of a night owl. And that's fine. This works in the morning or in the evening. I would just challenge that thinking by saying, a lot of times it's a matter of just switching your hours. So if you want to get, if you need to get a certain number of hours of sleep, that's okay. You just need to go to bed early to get up earlier. And that's what I did. I need about 6 hours of sleep, and I used to go to bed around 11. I would get up around 5, and that was how my day would begin, 5 or 5:30. Now I've just moved that back in an hour. So I try to hit the sack by 10, I'm usually up at 4, and I can get so much done in the morning. Frankly, I can get more done by 6:30 when everybody wakes up in my house than most people I think can in an entire day. So let me tell you the three things that I think are critical to start your morning. First and foremost, I think it's really, really important to get in some exercise in the morning. It's very healthy for you. We all know the benefits of exercise, but the other thing it does is it clears your mind and it helps you prepare for the day. So getting at least 30 minutes of exercise where your heart rate is elevated. Maybe it's a brisk walk, maybe a jog. Certainly you could go lift and do that type of thing. But I just think even I typically just take a fast walk in the morning. While I do, I normally listen to some type of audiobook so that I'm learning and my mind is just beginning to work. I don't get to the office, get a cup of coffee, kind of get going, and maybe around 9 or 9:30 I'm actually functioning. I am ready to go and my mind is working very, very early. The second thing I think that is important in the morning before work begins is to have some type of quiet time, a time when, you know, for me, I use the Jesus Calling devotional. I spend about 30 minutes reading it, praying over it, praying to prepare for my day. Some people prefer meditation, but just getting yourself in the right frame of mind before your day begins, I think is very, very important. And then finally, planning your day. Take a look at your calendar, determine what you have going that day. Look at your to-do list. You should have a master to-do list with everything on it. Pick out the five or 10 things that are most important for that day. Make sure that you're gonna get those things done. Figure out how you're gonna block out the time to get them done so that when you arrive at the office, you are ready to go. You know exactly what you're going to accomplish that day, you know when you're gonna do it, and you can immediately become productive. The other thing I love to do in the mornings if I have time is do reading that I wanna get done. I try to make it through all of my emails and text messages from the day before so that I know who I need to get back to, so people aren't waiting to hear back from me. And I think that's a great way to start your day as well, because you're fresh, you're caught up, you're not behind, people aren't waiting on a response from you. So I just overall, I think that managing your morning is a critical skill as it becomes as you want to become a better time manager. So I hope you've enjoyed this edition of Regent Elevate. Next week, we're going to talk about the magic of two-hour living. Tune in and we'll explain that when we see you next week. Thank you.